Welcome back, everyone. We just wrapped up Senior Pet Month and how to care for your aging pet. And while dogs and cats may come to mind first, Dane County actually has an incredibly high population of horses. We are talking today with Dr. Keith Colson. He works with large animal medicine at the UW Veterinary Clinic. Thanks for joining us.
Oh, thanks for coming.
You know, usually when we're talking about pets, we talk in terms of cats and dogs. But Dane County and the surrounding areas here actually have a really large horse population, don't they?
Yeah, they do. A lot of pleasure horses or backyard and some performance horses that people bring in. And as the city grows, it's obviously moving outside of the city, but as the metropolitan area grows, it's also going to include more people. So we are seeing more and more horses.
And as you're seeing more horses, the reason we're here today is you're seeing people holding on to their horses a lot longer. You're seeing older and older horses coming in. So special care that's needed in terms of an aging horse.
Yeah, well, we really think about aging horses as really four big points. And one of them is don't forget about them. So a lot of people that have horses and they're performance horses or riding horses, when they're retired, when they can't perform as they did 10 years ago, we don't want to forget about them. They had jobs and they really like doing those jobs. They're social animals. So they really need to have that constant daily attention. Whether or not, if it's not you out training and riding the horse, they still need a buddy. They need another horse out there to socialize with, or we have some clients that have goats as social animals, or they just have their owners out there hand walking them or light riding, and it still needs to happen every day for the horse's mental well-being. And then we kind of get into the next really important part, would be keeping a good body condition on the horse. So we don't want horses to get too fat and we don't want them to get too thin. In an area like this, we see a lot of horses that are really overweight, and that has some long-term health consequences, and that's really the same in people, dogs, and cats.
Make sure they're getting exercise.
Right, not overfed. Exercise and not overfed is the biggest part, and they're out on pasture. Along with that, on the other end of that spectrum, with horses that have not enough body condition, it's because senior horses don't absorb the same amount of nutrients as that a middle-aged or a younger horse. So it's really important to have high fiber in the diet and an increased protein along with plenty of vitamins and minerals, because they don't absorb as they did earlier in life.
Which is something if they're having routine vet care.
Right, routine vet care consultation with a nutritionist and then their veterinarian.
So okay.
The next thing we think about was, it's the same with older dogs and people, is that you really have to pay attention to their teeth. Because you think about, that's what they do for a living. They're out chewing grass all day long. They really need to have an equine dentist, which is usually your veterinarian. There are equine dentists that are specialists, but they need to have their teeth, what we call floated, or dental prophylaxis at least once or twice a year. And if they have problems, it might need to be a little bit more frequent. So we're really looking to keep that occlusal surface of the teeth nice and flat so they can chew their food properly and digest it.
So maintain an active lifestyle, mm-hmm. a healthy weight, and keep their teeth in good shape.
Teeth.
You should expect your horse to live.
Well, it's really not uncommon to see horses in their mid-30s, and we've had miniature horses and ponies in their 40s, too. So up into the 40s is a little more rare, but certainly into the low to mid-30s, they're a lifelong pet.
If you'd like more information on caring for an aging horse or any other pet, we do have some links for you, including to the UW's veterinary medicine program at NBC15.com. Well, it is the earliest start in 20 years still ahead today at 11. The impact this year's early Hanukkah could play on holiday sales. We're back in just a minute.